Kimberlite is an igneous rock and rare variant of peridotite. It is most commonly known to be the main host matrix for diamonds. It is named after the town of Kimberley in South Africa, where the discovery of an 83.5 carat, 16.70 grams, diamond called the Star of South Africa in 1869 spawned a diamond rush and the digging of the open pit mine called the Big Hole. Previously, the term Kimberlite has been applied to olivine lamproites as Kimberlite II, however this has been an error. Forsteritic olivine and carbonate minerals, with trace amounts of magnesian ilmenite, chromium pyrope, almandine-pyrope, chromium diopside, phlogopite, enstatite and titanium poor chromite. Sometimes contains diamonds. Kimberlite occurs in the earth crust in vertical structures known as kimberlite pipes, as well as igneous dikes. Kimberlite also occurs as horizontal sills. 2. Kimberlite pipes are the most important source of mined diamonds today. The consensus on kimberlites is that they are formed deep within the mantle. Formation occurs at depths between 150 and 450 kilometers, 93 and 280 miles, potentially from anomalously enriched exotic mantle compositions, and they are erupted rapidly and violently, often with considerable carbon dioxide, 3, and other volatile components. It is this depth of melting and generation that makes kimberlites prone to hosting diamonds and agarists. Despite its relative rarity, kimberlite has attracted attention because it serves as a carrier of diamonds and garnet peridotite mantle zeolites to the Earth's surface. Its probable derivation from depths greater than any other igneous rock type, and the extreme magma composition that it reflects in terms of low silica content and high levels of incompatible trace element enrichment, make an understanding of kimberlite petrogenesis important. In this regard, the study of kimberlite has the potential to provide information about the composition of the deep mantle and melting processes occurring at or near the interface between the cratonic continental lithosphere and the underlying convecting asthenospheric mantle. Many kimberlite structures are emplaced as carat-shaped, vertical intrusions termed pipes. This classic carat shape is formed due to a complex intrusive process of kimberlitic magma, which inherits a large proportion of CO2. Lower amounts of H2O, in the system, which produces a deep explosive boiling stage that causes a significant amount of vertical flaring. 4. Kimberlite classification is based on the recognition of differing rock facies. These differing facies are associated with a particular style of magmatic activity, namely crater, diatreme and hypabyssal rocks. The morphology of kimberlite pipes and their classical carat shape is the result of explosive diatreme volcanism from very deep mantle-derived sources. These volcanic explosions produce vertical columns of rock that rise from deep magma reservoirs. The eruptions forming these pipes fracture the surrounding rock as it explodes, bringing up unaltered zeolites of peridotite to surface. These zeolites provide valuable information to geologists about mantle conditions and composition. 7. The morphology of kimberlite pipes is varied, but includes a sheeted dike complex of tabular, vertically dipping feeder dikes in the root of the pipe, which extends down to the mantle. Within 1.5 to 2 kilometers, 0.93 to 1.24 miles, of the surface, the highly pressured magma explodes upwards and expands to form a conical to cylindrical diatreme, which erupts to the surface. The surface expression is rarely preserved but is usually similar to a mar volcano. Kimberlite dikes and sills can be thin, 1 to 4 meters, while pipes range in diameter from about 75 meters to 1.5 kilometers.